Where it occurs is here in Kern County. But a lot of it occurred in San Bernardino County, which is our neighbor to the east. The crime itself happened in Tehachapi. It happened in Tehachapi on August 17th, 2014. Robert Lamone, Sabrina Lamone, their two children, Robbie Lamone and Leanna Lamone, lived in Hellendale. It's a small desert community just north of Victorville. As you can see, it's kind of northeast from Los Angeles. Highway 15 on its way to Las Vegas is just kind of off towards the west. They lived in Hellendale. Particularly, they lived at a residence 27250 Strawberry Lane. Their residence. Now, during this time, Robert worked for Burlington Northern Santa Fe Railroad, or BNSF for short. Primarily, he worked up in Barstow. There's a big rail yard up there. That's where he would go on most of his duty days. He'd go, he'd work 8 hours. In the time just before his death in 2014, Robert also began working as what's called a rapid responder. He did that up in Tehachapi. He would do that about 2 to 4 days a month. And what he did as a rapid responder is kind of spell other people that worked up at the industrial complex there in Tehachapi. So if somebody had a vacation day, somebody had a sick day, they'd give him a call. Robert would come up and cover those duties. A rapid responder is somebody who kind of went in the work truck if a train broke down on the railway up Hatchby Loop, they'd work on the trains there. This is the industrial complex where the BNSF shop is located at, just off the freeway. Now, around that same time, Sabrina Lamone got a job at Costco. This is the Costco in Victorville. She worked there for a while. To the south of Victorville is Hesperia. Living in that location is Jonathan. Jonathan Hearn was a firefighter. One of his duties as a firefighter was to go and buy food for the fire station. He was a firefighter in Redlands, California. And so during the course of his duties, working as a firefighter, living in Hesperia, he would go to Costco to buy the food. And in that time, in 2012, he met Sabrina Lamont. Immediately after they met, in the months following, they began an affair. This is 2012. Now, throughout the next few years, this affair continued and ultimately led to the death of Robert Lamone. Robert Lamone, you will hear witness after witness get up there and say how hardworking he was, about how he was a friend to everyone. He was a father of two. And throughout this trial, you will hear from the mouth of Sabrina Lamone and Jonathan Hearn, that they had a purpose, they had a plan, and that plan was to get rid of Robert Lamone. Why? So they could be together. Why? So she could get in excess of $300,000 in life insurance money, and also that she could get lifelong benefits from the railroad because Robert was killed while working at the railroad in Tehachapi. You will hear 2012, 2013, information about the affair. Text messages back and forth. Countless text messages. Countless phone calls. You will see photos sent by Ms. Lamone. You will see letters that were written, because there were some breaks in the relationship in 2013. Letters written by Jonathan in one of the breaks that happened in April of 2013, and then also in November of 2013. You will also hear evidence about Robert finding out about the affair and confronting Jonathan Hearn. This happened in April 2013 and also in March of 2014. Into 2014, the affair continued. The evidence relating to 2014, one of the items that you'll get in this case, is the Valentine's Day letter from Sabrina Lamont to Jonathan Hearn. I'll read that for you. My Jonathan, this is from from February 14, 2014, approximately 6 months before Robert was killed.
At this point, I'm going to object to have not submitted any evidence.
Mr. Smith, you have a good faith belief that'll be admitted during the course of the trial?
Yes, Your Honor.
Objections noted, overruled.
Thank you. My Jonathan, I love you. I love you for finding the part of me that I never thought I'd find. I love you for wanting and needing me by your side. I love you for trusting me with your heart, your pride, your wisdom, and your soul. I love you for the intimate exchange we share. I love you for me being the one you choose to care for. I love you for the special meaning you have brought to my life. I love you for the hopes and faith in our future together. I love you for giving me a new perspective on life. I love you for wanting to live for God. I love you for seeing me more than my parts and pieces and loving all of who I am. I love you for believing in me and all that I have to offer. I love you for so many reasons. I've only written a few, but in all that years bring to us, I never want to forget that you were made for me and I was made for you. Your first love, Sabrina. About 1 month after that, they began to plan the murder of Robert Lamont. Initially, they decided on poisoning as a way to kill Robert. Part of the steps, you heard the overt acts that were read to you. Jonathan purchased some arsenic trioxide, got a fake PayPal account, purchased it from an art supply company, had that shipped to his residence. He also researched how to kill with arsenic using his Google email. You will hear about the plan, the purpose, the plan. They were going to put some poison into his lunch. That lunch would go with him to Tehachapi, and he would presumably eat that lunch and die. You will hear at the end of April, Jonathan did indeed mix a batch of arsenic into some pudding. He made a large batch. From that batch, he put a smaller amount into a second Tupperware, mixed the arsenic into that, took the two batches to Miss Lamone's home in Hellendale. One was obviously for consumption by Robert. One was just so it didn't look out of the ordinary that there was an item full of pudding. That Tupperware containing the arsenic was put into Robert's lunch. He went to work with the arsenic in his lunch. At some point during the day, Miss Lamone, Jonathan Hearn were kind of talking about what if we get caught, what could lead us to get caught. And they kind of settled on, well, since there is so many phone calls, there is so many text messages, one of the easiest ways would, of course, be for them to trace our phones. So because of that, they decided to call off the poisoning. And that day, the next day, Jonathan Hearn bought what you will hear Sabrina Lamone later call a burner phone. Now that they have the burner phone, the phone calls continue, the text messaging continues, and they continue to plan the murder of Robert Lamone. But they settled on Jonathan going to Tehachapi and shooting and killing Robert. Now, Jonathan took over the primary planning of going to Tehachapi because he was the one that was going to do it. You will hear how Jonathan Hearn was actually getting trained how to be an arson investigator. So he was a firefighter. He was wanting to be in law enforcement portion of working as a firefighter. Some of the things that he did, purchased what's called a murder kit or clothes from Salvation Army to kind of hide what he looked like. He purchased a mask. He built a silencer out of a flashlight. What did Sabrina do? Well, she provided information. She had been up to Tehachapi to the BNSF shop, which, by the way, is extremely hard to find. There is no markings on that building. There is a single parking curb that says BNSF on it. So she provided information about where the shop is located. Jonathan Hearn actually reconned or did reconnaissance of the shop on a trip back from Monterey, May 23rd, 2014. Took photos of the location, and all throughout this time, he was on the phone with Sabrina Lamont. She would also keep him informed of the days Robert worked in Tehachapi. And that's what ultimately happened. August 16th, Robert Lamone gets the call. Can you come work for me? Robert goes to work August 17, 2014. Jonathan Hearn gets off of work in Redlands, heads home the whole way on the phone with Sabrina. He gets to his residence, gets everything together, talks to her for about 80 minutes, gets on his motorcycle, heads to Tehachapi. When he gets to Tehachapi, you will see video of this. He walks through the yard at Goodrick Road, ultimately comes to the BNSF shop. The doors are open to the shop. He looks in. Robert's there, actually offers him a drink. Robert Lamone offered Jonathan Hearn a drink, because that's the kind of guy he was. Jonathan Hearn pulled out a gun, shot and killed Robert Lamone. That day, Jonathan Hearn shot Robert twice. Robert lay there, dying. Jonathan Hearn onto his motorcycle, left the area, drove home. Immediately when he got home, the first thing, person he contacted was Sabrina Lamont. Contacted her via text, contacted her via phone. You also hear about the investigation in this case. You will hear about the initial contact that law enforcement had with Sabrina Lamont. And in any of these investigations, what do they ask? They want to know who had a problem with Robert, or if a wife had an extramarital affair. You will hear information that Sabrina Lamone denied that Robert Lamone had any beefs with anybody, even though you'll hear that Jonathan Hearn and him had gotten into it. You will hear that Sabrina Lamone denied that she had an extramarital affair, even though she had a very long-standing affair with Jonathan Hearn. The investigation into Sabrina and Jonathan only began because family friends, Jason and Kelly Bernatine, kind of got a random letter from Jonathan and also saw Jonathan at Sabrina's home in the days following Robert's murder. And this kind of piqued their interest. Like, what's this guy doing? And because of that, they called law enforcement. Law enforcement said, who's Jonathan Hearn? They were able to get his DMV information. And sure enough, he had a motorcycle. That motorcycle matched some of the surveillance footage, or looked like the motorcycle on the surveillance footage. And from that, they began the investigation. Now, while the investigation was going on, because Robert was killed in August, the investigation took September, October, November before an arrest actually happened. Sabrina and Jonathan actually basically started a new life together. Jonathan Hearn would go over to her residence in Hellendale. Usually he would bring a family member in tow, just so it didn't look out of the ordinary. He would also come and stay the night. She would call him. He would go there late at night. After the kids were in bed, he would stay till the morning, and he would leave. Evidence will show some of the text messaging that went back and forth between Sabrina Lamone and Jonathan Hearn in this time frame. September 5th, 2014. This is 19 days after Robert had been killed. Sabrina sent the text message, "Oh, how I love you," saying September 5th, "I adore you, Jonathan Hearn, you sexy guy." September 7th, 21 days after Robert had been killed, "I want to kiss you right now and not stop." Another text message that same day, "Ah, my poor guy. I love you so much, baby. Miss you so much tonight. I feel God's purpose and strength working in my life and in our relationship. I love you, Jonathan." 25 days after Robert was killed on, basically 3 years ago today, September 11, 2014, "You are so good to me. We can only get better with God. That is so exciting. As so many look to others' lives and other things, we look to God. There is no greater peace to find. I feel super blessed." Again, this is 25 days after her husband had been shot and killed in Tehachapi. More text messaging on that same day, September 11th. "I got something practical for you today in town. It will one day be something we share in our home." That was part of their plan. That was part of their purpose. "We're going to kill Robert. We're going to get together. We're going to raise the kids together. They were going to have a home together." 26 days after Robert had been killed, "Baby, I love you so much." That's with 11 O's. That's how much she loved him. Moving on to October 5th, 2014. Baby, you are my partner in this life to live for God. I am so ready to live life fully for you. I will wait on God's time and trust in his plan, but I am ready for us. Ready for us is in all caps. I need you, my Jonathan. And then last 2 months after the murder of Robert Lamone, Sabrina sent this text. I am in love with you deeply, a love that I've never felt before. That includes her husband, who she was with in excess of 10 years. This is a love she had never felt before. As the investigation continued, November 6th, a wiretap went into place. On November 7th, Sabrina was told by some friends who had connections in BNSF that there was a possible wiretap going on. So you will hear the whole entirety of the wiretap, which took about 10 days. But a lot of that, they kind of knew that law enforcement was listening to them. What you can hear, though, is as little bits of information were provided by Detective Meyer, you can feel their voices get frantic. You can feel they know law enforcement is kind of closing in. And you will get that sense throughout the wiretaps. On November 18, 2014, Jonathan and Sabrina were both arrested. Sabrina told law enforcement that she had indeed told Jonathan where Robert worked and that Robert would be working the day of the murder. On November 20th, murder charges were brought against Jonathan. Sabrina was released from custody. This year, Jonathan Hearn agreed to testify against Sabrina Lamone for 25 years, 4 months in prison. Following that, she was arrested. Here we are. Evidence will show that Robert Lamone was killed for money. Evidence will show that Robert Lamone was killed to replace him as the father to Leanna and Robbie. So Leanna and Robbie could be brought up by godly parents. You will hear that Robert Lamone was removed as a husband, as a leader of the house, by both Sabrina and Jonathan. Again, this was their plan. This was their purpose. And at the end of the evidence, I will ask you to find Sabrina Lamone guilty beyond a reasonable doubt of the murder of the attempted murder of Robert Lamone, the solicitation to commit the murder of Robert Lamone, and the conspiracy to commit the murder of Robert